All right, so in this video, I'm gonna share with you the fastest way to set up your Facebook ads to generate sales for your clothing store. The first thing you need to do is make sure that you have your Facebook Business Manager set up, pixel installed, Facebook and Instagram shop process completed. There is a little bit of a process to get it all set up, but this is really simple to complete, and then a final approval by Facebook or Meta, and you're good to go. The next step you're going to need to take is creating content on Instagram and TikTok, or at the bare minimum, at least one of them. What I would suggest is to create 5 to 10 reels jumping on trending sounds, using these sounds to showcase your clothes in an interesting way. So here are some examples of videos that have done really well that you can copy. Like literally, I'm just gonna throw them up under the screen of 3 to 4 different types of trends that you can use for your clothing store. All right, so once you have your content, we'll need to jump into Ads Manager to build it. I'll show you step-by-step how to do it right here. All right, now that we're inside of Ads Manager, it's gonna be very simple setup here. We're gonna go ahead and click Create. You're gonna go down here to Sales. That is what you actually want. Advantage Plus Shopping Campaign. That is a really good option. You could test that if you'd like. I'm gonna do Manual Sales Campaign to have a little bit more control. Hit Continue. We always do this as the campaign name. For example, this could be Holiday Sales. You can label it whatever you'd like. That's just really your preference. Advantage Campaign Budget. This is CBO, or Campaign Budget Optimization. It means that the budget's gonna be distributed across multiple ad sets. This is the campaign level. I'm gonna go ahead and put this at $100. You could put it at 50, you could put it at 1,000, whatever that you feel that you can make per day or spend per day. I look at it as, what can I spend for the next 30 days and not have to worry about return and be comfortable with it? So what can you spend there? All right, ad scheduling, it's on. Nothing much to set up here. Ad set, this is where most people kind of get a little thrown off. So what we'll do is, I wanna make sure to label this. This ad set will be, let's just say Jazzy is the collection for our holiday here. It's one for purchase. Dynamic creative, this is the part you gotta make sure you turn on. This allows everything else to make sense. So the dynamic creative is what gives us the option to put multiple pieces of creative into our ad. So turn that on. Then we need to make sure that we know our audience. So right, what is your audience? If you're a streetwear brand, you may be trend lower, right? It's the 18 to 35, 38 year old. If you're a clothing boutique focused on women who have a little bit of money, right? You may be going after that 25 to 55, 60 year old woman. So I'm just gonna throw in here 18 to 64. Got an amazing brand that has a wide range. It's not gonna make too much of a difference on that as much, right, as far as age range. The other thing you wanna do though is choose gender. So I'm gonna choose women. This is a women's brand that I'm making up at this point. All languages, Advantage Plus placements. I would suggest manual. Just remove the audience network. Leave everything else on. Should be good to go. All right, one day, or everything's on there. One thing I do want to make sure, and they move it quite a bit. All right, right here. So very important attribution setting. So we do one day click or view. This is like an attribution, but also like it's what's ad is counted towards Facebook, but also is the optimization window. So we're trying to get Facebook to make these purchases within one day. All right, so go ahead and click through here, hit to the ad level, make sure that your Facebook page is selected, Instagram account is selected, just like I mentioned earlier. Ad preview we'll want to turn on. We can label this as whatever we want, Jazzy stuff. All right, single images. Want to make sure multi-advertiser ads help people discover your products when they show a commercial intent. All right, so this is new actually. Your ads may appear alongside ads from multiple businesses in Instagram feed. Cool, so that's actually pretty new. Haven't seen that before. I'm gonna select the images. You can select up to 10. We suggest 3 pieces of creative. So like one lifestyle photo, or sorry, you can do up to 4 really, but one lifestyle photo, one UGC type of content, one graphic, and then one like product photo if you have it. So we're gonna select images. I'm just gonna put in images that I have currently, 3 and then 4. I understand that these are a little bit different. Okay, they've all loaded. Like I said, I would rather have the 4 pieces of content that we've suggested here. Optimize creative for each person. I would not do that. What this does is, so vary your ad creative and destination based off each person's likelihood to respond. Test this out, but we have not seen so much success with it. But like I said, it's something worth potentially testing here. All right, scroll down. Okay, primary text, write in a couple of primary texts here. All right, so have a couple of headlines in here, have a couple of primary text as well. So test out your primary text, your headlines. We like to do 4-2-2. So 4 pieces of creative, photos, videos, graphics, etc. 2 pieces of primary text, 2 headlines. Make sure you put it in your website. You can do a display link if the website link is super long. I would always say that if this is going to a collection, make sure you put the collection URL here. And then if you want to do the display link, you may just do the root URL, which is just like the full name without the forward slash. All right, make sure the tracking is set on, turned on. Make sure you check the URL. This should already be done whenever you set up the pixel, so you should see it right here. If you have an app, make sure the app events are turned on as well. Make sure you choose the correct app event. If you have an app, that's probably something you already know about and how to set up, or you reach out to the company who helped you with that app. Other thing, if you have offline events, this is for your brick and mortar stores, you can set up offline events as well. And then if you use something like Triple Whale, which we highly suggest, which allows you to track purchases that happen more accurately on other places that maybe have your tracking turned off, you can put in the parameters here. And that is it. I always do a double check of everything one last time, make sure it's going for a website, make sure that it's going to the right audiences. Like I said, double check all of that and you would go ahead and click publish. Okay, so now that your ads are ready to be able to turn on, you'll wait for the review to complete and your ads will literally be live. Now, one thing that you do need to do is make sure that you review your content after a few days to find your winning ads. And once you find the winning ads, you can turn off the losers and begin to add more budget to the campaign level at 20% budget increase per day. So if you have any questions about setup or growing your clothing store, make sure that you watch our hundreds of other videos on advertising and using Shopify to grow your clothing store. Have a great day and we'll see you guys next time.